so excited about this video. Are you going on a trip but you don't have a lot of time? I'm Kat Young and I love helping people plan their trips. So I've got three tips for you today on how to simplify your travel plans. Tip number one, pick a few things that you think will make your trip a success. I usually go with landmarks. Why? Because whether it is the Eiffel Tower in Paris or the Freedom Tower in New York City, this is a way to feel sure that you can say, I went to Paris, I went to New York City. You've got the main landmarks covered. So I recommend picking out three and then looking them up online, seeing how long does it take you to get from your hotel or wherever you're staying to the place that you're trying to go. Is there a fee involved? And any specific things that you might need to wear. If you're going to be doing a lot of walking, for example, you might want to wear good walking shoes. So these are the things to keep in mind when you're picking out a few key places to check out for the city that you're going to. Tip number two, try a hop-on, hop-off bus tour. In most major cities in the world, you will be able to find a big bus tour, city sightseeing, or whatever the brand is. In just 2 to 4 hours, you get the lay of the land, and I just think it's a really great way to see the city above ground. I've been to London a lot of times, and just a couple of years ago, I decided to do another hop-on, hop-off bus tour, just to refresh my memory of the city. And it was great because it was a reintroduction and gave me the chance to look at the city in a new light. I saw some things that I hadn't seen in many years, and it was just a lot of fun. So whether you've been to the city many times and you're bringing new people, or it's your first time in a place, I think a hop-on, hop-off bus tour is a great way to go directly to the site that you want to see and do your research in person rather than doing it online. Tip number three, remember, you're supposed to enjoy yourself on your vacation, so take time and relax. I usually travel by myself, and, you know, I have a routine. I like to go to historic monuments and see the sights from sunup until sundown. When I traveled with my friend Tiffany, she reminded me of something very important. It's not a race to the finish line. Take the time to sit at a cafe, have a glass of wine, do some people watching. Don't forget that your trip is about enjoying yourself. It's not about seeing everything in a place. If you don't have a lot of time, you want to make the most of it and take a moment to reflect on why you went on this trip in the first place. So, these are my three tips. What are the challenges that you face as you're planning your next trip? Please comment below. All right, thanks so much.